What a racing prospect. The lights go from red, they're off. There's another good start by Loris Capirossi. A very good start, though, indeed, by Alex Barros.
I think Olivier Jacques actually nicked there at the front. Jacques leading the way, but Capirossi has the extra speed on the Ducati at the end of the straight. Capirossi leads the way. Rossi round the outside into second place. Givinau up on the inside of Jacques for third, and I think he just shoved out Jacques to fourth there.
Capirossi leads the way. Here comes Rossi trying to go up the inside. They've started already. Capirossi holds first. Givinau up the inside of Max Biaggi. Biaggi, though, hangs on to third place, but Rossi has taken the lead. It's closing up at the front, no doubt about it. Rossi still leads the way. 16 laps to go. Loris Capirossi in second place. Max Biaggi third. Sete Givinau fourth. And the three Italians, we saw them in Mugello, didn't we, a week ago, are at it once again. This time it's in Barcelona.
Not really paying any attention to have a change of the lead. Loris Capirossi now in front of Valentino Rossi. What a cheer from the Spanish crowd. What a race at the front. We thought that that Rossi had this in his pocket. He hasn't. Loris Capirossi has gone in front. Rossi looks over his shoulder.
We ride with the world champion right behind the Ducati now of Loris Capirossi.
I'm just down here on pit lane with five times 500cc world champion Mick Doohan as Valentino Rossi goes around the outside and runs wide again.
Valentino Rossi off the track and into the gravel. What a disaster for Valentino Rossi. He was pushing so hard to stay with Capirossi at the front. Now, where is he going to come back in as he comes back onto the track? Look at the faces on the Ducati mechanics. Capirossi now a clear leader here. He's got plenty of track space behind him where the fight for second place goes on between Biaggi and Givinau. Problems for Valentino Rossi.
Right, we ride with Valentino Rossi, three laps to go. The man in front of him, Shinya Nakano, is going to try and outbreak him at the end of the straight. I absolutely promise you. And he is on the brake, Valentino Rossi. He goes past Nakano as if he's absolutely standing still. He's now up into fifth place. Surely he can't win this race with three laps to go.
Rossi comes up on the inside of Checa already and he goes after those two Hondas. What a performance from Valentino Rossi. He's run off the track once, but he's back in it now after coming back in sixth place. He's just shaving tenths of seconds, half of seconds, full seconds off these guys.
At the front, Loris Capirossi still holds the advantage. And look at Rossi. He's gone past Biaggi as if he's absolutely standing still. Biaggi fights back side by side. Biaggi's not going to let him go through. Oh, Rossi up the inside. Round those double right-handers. What a performance by the Italian. Rossi now up into third place. Where will this end with two laps to go?
Well, we used to get treated to this sort of performance 2 years ago. Rossi was notorious for getting bad starts and then fighting his way through the field, and we used to be able to enjoy this all the time. We've not got used to it recently because he's been dominating, but he is streaking through the field. He's got past Givinau at the end of the straight. He's back up to second place, and he's got two full laps to catch Loris Capirossi.
Capirossi comes into the final right-hand bend. The chequered flag is being ready for the Italian. The chequered flag is being ready for Ducati. Capirossi gives Ducati their first MotoGP victory. What a ride by Rossi into second place. Sete Givinau finishes third. Carlos Checa fourth. Shinya Nakano in fifth place. The celebration start in the Ducati pit.
If you like these videos, click here and here. If you like more videos like this,